First, you will connect to XSCS database using SQL Developer. In SQL Developer, you'll add a column to the employees table in your database. This is going to be done by first running the following query to connect to your pluggable database. You can see that the session's been altered in the script output. Next, on our SQL Developer sheet, we're going to run the following two commands to add a last name column to the employees table. We will now keep this tab open because we're going to return to it to a later step. Now we'll sign into the Oracle DataSafe console in our region. In the Oracle DataSafe console, click the Library tab and then click Sensitive Data Models. Select the checkbox for your sensitive data model that you created in Discovery Lab 1. Discover sensitive data with Oracle DataSafe. Now click Verify against Target. On the Select Target for Data Model Verification page, select your target database and click Continue. The verification job is started. When the job is finished, notice that the detail column reads Data Model Verification Job Finished Successfully. Click Continue. On the Data Model Verification Result page, notice that there are no differences to the report. The verification job did not find the new sensitive column, last name. The verification feature checks whether the sensitive columns in the sensitive data model are present in the target database. If there are some present in the sensitive data model but missing in the target database, it reports them. In addition, it reports new referential relationships for the columns already present in the sensitive data model. It does not, however, discover all the relationships. Click Continue. Now we're going to manually add the age column to our sensitive data model. On the sensitive data model page, click Add. This Add Sensitive Columns dialog box is displayed. Expand the HCM1 schema and then the employees table. Select the last name column. At the top of the dialog box in the sensitive type field, enter last name. Last name is automatically retrieved as a sensitive type and you can select it. Scroll to the bottom and click Add to Result. Your sensitive data model is updated to include the last name column. To verify, enter last name in the search box. HCM1.employees.lastname should be listed. Click Save and Continue. Click Exit. Now we're going to return to SQL Developer. We're going to be dropping the last name column from our database in these next few steps. On the SQL worksheet, run the following command to drop the HCM1.employees.lastname column. Now we'll run the following command to gather schema statistics. Now we'll verify that employees no longer has a last name column. We're going to run the following script. Notice that the last name column is gone and you receive an invalid identifier message when you run the command. Now we're going to verify our sensitive data model against the database again, but this time using the Data Discovery Wizard. We'll return to Oracle DataSafe. Click the Home tab and then click Data Discovery. On the Select Target for Sensitive Data Discovery page, select your target database and then click Continue. The Select Sensitive Data Model page is displayed. For Sensitive Data Model, select Pick from Library and then click Continue. The Select Sensitive Data Model page is displayed. Select your sensitive data model. Scroll down to the bottom of the page and select Verify if SDM is compatible with the target. To start the verification job, click Continue. When the job finishes successfully, click Continue. The Data Model Verification Result page is displayed. Now we will expand the missing sensitive columns and then HCM1. The Data Discovery Wizard identifies the last name column as missing from the database. You can manually update your sensitive data model while continuing to work in the Data Discovery Wizard, in which case you simply deselect your sensitive column and save your sensitive data model. This part, however, shows you another way to do it from the library. Click Exit to exit the Data Discovery Wizard. Click the Library tab, and then click Sensitive Data Models. Click your Sensitive Data Model to open it. Search for last name. In the list of sensitive columns, deselect HCM1.employees.lastname. Your sensitive data model is now updated and accurate. Click Save, then Exit. Now you've completed Lab 7, Part 5, Verify a Sensitive Data Model with Oracle DataSafe.